Every modern gadget requires an electric connection or a battery. Many materials have been tested, but a new battery material has arrived and shocked the entire industry. It's a nuclear diamond battery with a lifespan of 28,000 years. Welcome to Tech That Shapes Us. So what exactly is this new battery, and why is everyone excited about it? Join us today as we bring you everything you need to know about the incredible nuclear diamond battery. Let's start with how old batteries work and how this battery is 100 times better. Lithium-ion batteries. Nuclear diamond batteries are a giant leap from the standard lithium-ion batteries. These batteries have undoubtedly played a massive role in the proliferation of electronic devices, and because of their low energy density, shortcomings are most visible in electric vehicles. Lithium-ion batteries must be heavy to provide adequate driving ranges, but still, they lag behind gas-powered cars in terms of distance covered on a full tank, causing some people to be skeptical of electric vehicles. Apart from that, these batteries also take a long time to charge. One issue that all lithium-ion batteries face is degradation, which gradually causes them to lose capacity over time. This problem is more visible in gadgets such as smartphones, where batteries may struggle to hold a decent charge after a few years of use. We've all experienced it. In electric cars, you will notice that batteries do not last as long as they did when new, and you will have to change the battery when degradation reduces the capacity to a certain percentage, even if the rest of the car is still excellent. So, scientists have been experimenting with various battery materials and compositions to arrive at the perfect storm. For example, preference has been given to solid-state batteries rather than lithium-ion batteries. The nuclear diamond battery. When an atom's nucleus has an excess of particles and releases some of them to achieve a more stable ratio of protons to neutrons, a type of ionizing radiation known as beta radiation is produced, which involves a large number of high-speed, high-energy electrons, or positrons known as beta particles. A typical beta voltaic cell comprises thin layers of radioactive material sandwiched between semiconductors. Beta particles are released as the nuclear material decays, which knocks electrons loose in the semiconductor, resulting in an electric current. Nuclear batteries are significantly less efficient than other types of batteries, but there is a solution for this: polycrystalline diamond. To build this kind of battery, layers of nano diamonds are used. A publication of the University of Houston says that these diamonds show 3-4% greater conductivity when compared to silver and copper. These diamonds are made using chemical vapor deposition and are energy intensive and even more costly than naturally occurring diamonds. They are primarily blue and possess higher conductivity than the other diamond. Blue diamonds also happen naturally but are rare, so cheaper ones are made artificially. After obtaining the nano diamonds, NDB combines them with radioactive isotopes derived from nuclear waste. According to Golgotsy, they use radioactive isotopes of uranium and plutonium. The CEO of NDB, Nima, says the nano diamond battery cell's small size is an advantage for scalability. Take, for example, a wristwatch battery. It consumes around 2 microwatts. A much smaller NDB cell would suffice, he explains. We can increase the number of stacked cells if we need to power a different application to meet the demand. Still, the issue of wear and tear of the nuclear waste is implanted inside the diamond cells, creating a natural structural weakness that, statistically speaking, will eventually fail in some of the cells over time, according to Golgotsy. When the nano diamond battery becomes widely available in the future, some of the cells may break or go to waste with the devices they power. This creates a nuclear waste problem, which is unavoidable if many batteries are used, Golgotsy says. That does not imply that these batteries are not worthwhile. Take, for example, a child who gets a hearing aid implanted or an elderly person who gets a pacemaker. People shouldn't have to go through potentially traumatic surgery more than once, Golsharifi explains. According to NDB, the batteries could even be helpful in space vehicles that must operate for years without assistance. Take satellites, for example. Voyager, NASA's iconic space probe launched in September 1977 to study the outer solar system, was powered by three multi-hundred-watt radioisotope thermoelectric generators. The power output of each generator began at 158 watts. When combined, they will power high-energy electronics on Earth, such as LED displays on tablets and mobile phones. The NDB claims that the battery will last 28,000 years is based partly on these low-power space applications. NDB intends to launch its first commercial product, a smartwatch, sometime in 2022. NDB keeps its cards close to its chest, revealing only a few of the Nano Diamond battery's finer points, its power density, for instance. There are no video demonstrations of the technology either. The promise of the radioactive diamond battery remains very real, and NDB's upcoming smartwatch will reveal a lot about the viability of such technology in other applications. Thank you for watching. What do you think about the Nano Diamond battery? Remember to subscribe if you want updates on technology. See you in the next one.